Hello there you awesome possums. Today I bring you 10 free horror games on Steam without jump scares. Just a quick note that these games are all short, casual, and some aren't strictly horror or heavy on the horror elements. However, these are perfect if you're new to the genre, or if you want to give some friends or family a mild but fun little scare. So in number 10 we have The Flicker of Hope. If this absolutely amazing 2020 side-scrolling horror game looks familiar, then that's because this game was heavily inspired by Little Nightmares, according to one of the 18 student developers. That's right, those guys were students. Amazing. Anyway, in Flicker of Hope, you play a, cute, but questionably shaped candle with a rather questionable ability. Without spoiling too much, the game's objective is to escape the creepy castle without getting caught and without your light going out. Okay, Flicker of Hope isn't particularly scary per se. However, just like its inspiration, it maintains an eerie, dark, and creepy tone, giving the game a different kind of scary. As for how long the game is, I'd say it's about 20 minutes to half an hour. So if you've played Little Nightmares 1 or 2, then Flicker of Hope would be right up your alley. If not, then I still highly recommend giving this game a shot, because I absolutely loved it and it has a ton of good reviews. Next up is Escape Room The Sick Colleague. Okay, in this escape room game, there are two rooms. Room number 1, The Sick Colleague, and room number 2, Barbara's Secret. Unfortunately, due to legal problems, room number 1 has been disabled indefinitely. I say unfortunately because room number 1 had the more creepy vibe of the two. However, room number 2, Barbara's Secret, has its fair share of creepiness to it. So the game starts off with placing a checkmark on the typical escape room checklist: claustrophobic room, having no clue what the hell you're supposed to do, and a shelf. Because apparently there are always shelves in escape rooms, even IRL. At first, the game is simple enough. Solve some puzzles, open locks and doors, and so on. But as the game progresses, more disturbing things are revealed, and let's just leave it at that to avoid spoilers. Now, strictly speaking, this game isn't really horror, but it can rather make you feel uneasy. This game will take about an hour to complete, but of course it depends on how quickly you go through the puzzles. Moving on to number 8, The Static Speaks My Name. Time for a bit of a serious talk here. This game covers really heavy subjects like depression and suicide, so if you're uncomfortable with the topic, then by all means do not play this game and skip to the next one. I'm saying it again, this game has a mental health struggle element to it, so please skip this if you find the topic uncomfortable. Now that we've cleared that up, let's quickly talk about the game. Once again, this game is not on the horror side of things, but because of the subject it covers, the atmosphere can get really unsettling. The game starts with you doing some typical house chores. Nothing out of the ordinary, no puzzles, no creepy background noises, yet the game makes you feel uneasy in a psychological sense as you go through all the rooms. This game should take about 10 or so minutes to complete, and there's a good chance after finishing the game, you'll be staring at your screen with a blank expression. Gameplay-wise, there's not much going on like the graphics or movement or music, but still, of these 10 games I played, this one really hit me. P.S. The ending, or I guess the post-credit scene, is quite thought-provoking. Next on number 7 is a much lighter Rough Night at the Gallery. Okay, I know I said there are no jump scares on this list, but to be honest, I'm not really sure this counts. In the description it says, Rough Night at the Gallery is an adorable short-form horror masterpiece featuring art, dogs. I mean, as soon as you see the word dogs in a horror game description, you think how bad can this be? So the game is super simple. Collect some keys and proceed to the next room without getting licked by these scary dogs, apparently. Alright, I know I said there are no jump scares here, but you know, even though I still think this does not qualify, the least I could do is show this jump scare so you know what you're getting yourself into. That's not too bad, right? It is indeed quite adorable, actually. At the beginning of the video, I said you can give some of your friends or family a small fright with these games, and I think Rough Night at the Gallery is a good place to start. Show this game to your friends, kids, nephews, nieces, parents, or the pizza guy for all I care, and have a good laugh afterwards. On a bit more serious side of things, but not too serious, is Faded Grey. Faded Grey is one of those walking simulator games, and you play as a girl who recalls bits and pieces of her accident through interacting with some regular household objects. Like other games on the list, Faded Grey is short and can be completed in 15 to 20 minutes. This game actually looks pretty good, although it has some frame rate issues, but still, it has its moments. Good graphics and ambient sounds, and definitely has a creepy and spooky atmosphere. Also, it's worth mentioning that Faded Grey is a promo for another game from the same developer called Gate to Site 8. I personally haven't tried Gate to Side 8, but after watching the trailers, it's pretty much a longer version of Faded Grey, which I might actually try soon. On number 5, we have Rhome. Still in the world of walking simulators, Rhome takes place in a huge mansion with maybe 100 rooms, because rich people, am I right? The game is really simple. You explore the house, you pick up objects, and start small dialogues. However, it gets a bit trippy as you progress, and you will start hearing creepy ambient noises, but again, I promise there are no jump scares. And by no jump scares, I mean there are no monsters or creatures chasing you or jumping on your face. So I can't say the same for inanimate objects or lightning. The game takes about 15 to 20 minutes to complete, and while there are a few puzzles, they're all incredibly easy and shouldn't take you more than a couple of seconds to complete. Next up on number 4 is The Perfect Vermin. Now, The Perfect Vermin can be considered as a single-player office prop hunt, and again will take about 15 to 20 minutes. So in this game, you're in an office setting and you destroy chairs, tables, toilets, you know, typical stuff you find in an office. The goal is to reveal the hidden vermin disguised as an office item. While the game sounds like a typical Monday at the office, not everything is what it seems, because as you play and retry the game, things will get more and more unsettling, slowly revealing a cryptic-ish message. I was really surprised when I played this game for the first time. I was like, how could this be under the horror genre? And surely enough, I got it. Now, I'm not spoiling anything here because it's best to leave that hidden message for your own interpretation. But I can almost guarantee you, your jaw will drop at least halfway for at least 15 seconds after noticing the message. On number 3 is Greetings. Oh boy, this one's just absolutely terrifying. Alien Isolation has got nothing in this one, nothing. So be sure to have extra underwear ready when you play this game. Okay, seriously though, this game takes about a minute or two to finish. I'm not revealing anything, but that duration already says a lot. I'm telling you this because this game is perfect if you want to play a prank on a friend or a family member who is just terrified at the slightest mention of horror. And don't worry, there are still no jump scares, only a good yet confused laugh at the end. And on number 2 is My Friend is a Raven. This one is a bit more serious than the last one. My Friend is a Raven is about a post-apocalyptic world that was caused by some sort of a plague. This game was released at the end of 2019, and as we all know, the end of 2019 was the start of something some of us still live with today.
Coincidence? I think not!
Anyway, My Friend is a Raven isn't super scary, but thanks to its beautiful art style and audio, it creates a spooky atmosphere. The game has 4 endings and would take about 40 minutes to an hour to get them all. And finally on number 1 is September 1999. Okay, this game will take 5 minutes or less to complete, but do not let that game length fool you. The game takes place in a small house with 2 accessible rooms. While there are no monsters or ghosts, the game creates a terrifying atmosphere with its photorealistic graphics and 90s camcorder POV. Now, there are a few more things that make September 1999 unsettling, but I'd leave that for you to experience. However, I can assure you this game is one of the best free, short, and casual horror games out there. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay awesome, Possum.